Hello guys, welcome to my channel. My name is Samiza and this is how I celebrate Eid Mubarak video. In this video, you guys will see me do some cleaning and reorganizing plus cooking. Yes, you heard it right, because as I have mentioned in my previous videos, I moved into the house earlier this year, so I thought it would be special if I can actually celebrate Eid Mubarak for the first time in the house, and it would be even more special if I can show a little bit of our culture and tradition and celebrate Eid Mubarak with you guys. As my mom usually do 1 or 2 days before Eid, we normally use that time to clean up the whole house, sort of reorganizing furniture and stuff. And that's when we can have some siblings bonding. I remember when I was a kid, my mom used to divide the chores among us, so each person has something to do. Someone will have to clean the dust, others will have to maybe mop around the house and fill in the jar with some Eid cookies. But since I am living with a friend in this house, I thought this would be a great time for us to, as I said, celebrate Eid Mubarak in the house. So we start off by cleaning and reorganizing everything in the living room. It wasn't really a mess because we rarely spend time in the living room, but I just wanted everything to look neat and clean. So after all the organizing, my friend helped me to vacuum around the house. We also decided to clean out the balcony and rearrange the plants. I didn't really give them much attention lately. I was so busy with other stuff in the house. So I thought this is a great time to give them extra care that they deserved. And after I finished with the plants, I went ahead and rearranged the chairs I have in my small balcony. After all those cleaning, we turned on the diffuser to diffuse essential oil around the living room. And diffuser is one of our favorite therapy at home, especially to wind down after a very long and tiring day. The night before Eid, my mom usually busy cooking the Eid dishes in the kitchen, and I usually busy packing my clothes because we will go back to my grandparents' house later that night. But since I don't go anywhere tonight, I decided to hang on this cute little lantern with the help of my housemate, of course, and we are ready to call it a night. It is Eid morning. We decided to start cooking the Eid dishes. I know it would be a chaos because I am not a great cook. I think you all can tell by looking at how awkwardly I hold the knife. And it is actually the first time I am cooking these dishes in my whole life. The dishes I decided to cook today is my mom's recipe. This is what my mom usually cook when it comes to eat, and this considered one of our traditional eat dishes. So today I will be cooking some lodeh, kuah kacang, and also ayam masak merah. It was a chaos, don't worry, I know. Anyway, I start off by cutting and preparing all the ingredients for the eat dishes that I'm gonna cook today. I'm not going to go into details about the recipe. This is obviously not a cooking channel. I just wanted to give you guys the rough idea of how we prepare for eat in my country.
Kalau mak aku tengok ni, apa kau buat ni kak? Salah semua ni. Astagfirullah, astagfirullah. Mak tak ajar macam ni kak.
After all the chaos, the dishes are done. It is time to put on the eat clothes and get ready. What you guys see me wearing in this video is our traditional clothes that we usually wear during special occasions such as wedding and of course Eid Mubarak. We call it baju kurung and it basically consists of two pieces, which are the long skirt and also the blouse. After I finish getting ready and do some makeup, I don't usually go crazy with my makeup because nobody has time for that. I took a bunch of selfies. This is actually me and my siblings' routine during the first day of Eid. We normally go around my grandparents' house to take pictures of us wearing our new Eid clothes. We also have a tradition of seeking forgiveness, or my family call it as sesi salam, that has been going on since I was a kid. And what we normally do is we queue based on our age. So basically my mom will seek forgiveness from my dad, and my sister will seek forgiveness from my dad, and then my mom, and the list goes on. But since I don't have that around here, me and my friend just enjoy the dishes that we cooked earlier and spend the time chit-chatting. We also have a tradition of giving duit raya or money that we put in an envelope to our family and friends. The amount of money depends on the person who gives the duit raya, but it is definitely not compulsory. After we eat and we take a whole lot of selfies, we usually go and visit our family members and friends, and that is basically how we celebrate Eid Mubarak. So alright guys, I think that's all for today. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Thank you so much for watching. Bye bye.